Hi everyone, me Muhammad Yassin, AccessTuff Solutions. Today we have a new episode related to Java Design Pattern series. Our episode today related to proxy design pattern. What's the meaning of the proxy design pattern and how we can apply the proxy design pattern? Before answering these questions, we have something to think about. Sometimes we ask ourselves, can we filter or control the request came from the clients? How we can cache the request? How we can log the request? How to secure the request from clients? By using the proxy design pattern, or I name it as a filter pattern. Let us start our presentation first, then apply the code. But after watching this episode, you will be a good expert in the proxy design pattern, and we'll apply how to create our cache server to cache the requests from clients. Maybe we will apply the in-memory or in-memory cache, or we can use the MongoDB as a cache server, and we cache or the save all requests from clients in caching server. This is, will help us to build more performance application. Let us start our presentation first.
Proxy pattern. The proxy pattern is a structural pattern. It's a kind of structural pattern. How we can create the structure for the object itself. This structure pattern. What is programmer think about? I think he thinking about what I thought before. He think about, can I filter the client requests before accessing the server? How can I caching, logging, tracking, and the client's requests? Okay, the proxy is a structural design pattern that provides an object that acts as a filter or interceptor for the real service. A proxy receives the client's requests, apply some business logic and rules like filtering, caching, securing, and logging, etc. And then pass the request to the service object. What do you mean of that? That there is a request from client, the client sends a request to the server. Before accessing the service, the proxy, like a firewall, is catch the request and do some business logic like filter the data or request, caching the response or request, securing and log the data and or the request information. After that, or after do this business logic, maybe they will take a decision to continue to the request, send request to the service or to another service, or cancel or response to the client. Let us discuss with this workflow. The client send the request from his application to get data from database, like any report, any data. Before he access need a service, this service will make transaction to database to retrieve the data and send to client. Here we add the proxy. The proxy has a critical task here, or critical mission here at this point, like a firewall before accessing the database. The client send request, the proxy will catch this request and make some filters here, some caching, some filtering, some securing. Then if we talk about the caching, before call the database, he search for this request in memory caching or a cache server. Then if found the data, it will respond directly. If there is no data matched, then call this service. The service will generate request for database and response again to the proxy. Then the proxy will store this cached data in cache server, then reply or response to the application client. This will increase the application performance and reduced the round trip to database direct, so that all requests will first stored in cache server, and the next time we'll get the data from the cache server there. The proxy pattern, there's some cases or some situation we can apply the proxy pattern, like a database transaction control. If we need to control the database transaction like commit rollback, so that we can use a proxy to control the database transaction. Sometimes we need to log the request or the client request transaction so that before handle or process the request, we can log the data in log server or a log file. Sometimes we need to cache the request or this response for the client. That will increase the performance wise or reduce the round trip to the database, so that we can use the proxy design pattern to caching the data request or response. Sometimes we need to filter the request itself. Maybe we use something like a filtering, that maybe some requests can accept it and another the other request we can reject based on business rule. Sometimes we need to make some load balancing for data. We can call or making like lazy loading or redistributing requests of different servers or different services, so that, or we can make a delay for the request so that we can use the proxy server to handle this loading balancing. Sometimes we can change the request details before send to the client. Sometimes the request ask for some data, and before send data or request to the client, to the service, we need to make some enrichment for this detail and add extra data before send the whole request to the proxy or the business service. This class diagram discuss the design pattern or the proxy design pattern. First of all, we have to implement the interface. This interface contains all operations will apply in the proxy service and the business service. In the proxy, why we have to apply the same interface? Because this will make easy to route between the proxy and the business. Okay, the client send request to the application. The proxy will cache this request and do some business logic here, like caching, transformation, filtering, caching, securing, logging. Some transaction will do here. After that, if the proxy need to call the business service, it will route to the business service. Business service will do some logic to call database or send email or something. Then after finish, this will route again to the proxy service. If proxy service need route again to the business, there is a round trip between business service and the proxy service. After finish, it will respond to the client. Our demo will be the caching server, create the caching to cache the response before send the response to the client. When the client send, this is the same internet proxy. Sometimes we need to prevent the user or client to access some internet websites, so that we have something like firewall or F5, anything to protect or to monitoring the request. The client send the request, the proxy will catch this request, make some business service and some logic, then route to the cache server or to test or production server. Our demo is related to book store. If the client need to download any book, first of all should enter the ISB number or international standard book number. This is a unique key for each book. If we have this ISBN number, we can download from our application. If I call this service to download this book, first of all, it will go to cache, not found in cache server, so that download from the base through the business server. Now if call again, okay, it's download directly from cache server. Many times now there's still the server, the book in cache server. Try to download another book like 5. Okay, giving the book that found. Let us search for another book. Okay, download from database through the business service. Download again now from cache store. What we did now, first of all, we have to create the interface. Book library contains download and clearing the cache. We have a business service and the proxy. The business service and proxy apply and implement the same interface. The business service will call the database, will go to the repository, and through the repository will find data from the database. Here, calling the repository. So that the business service will calling the database directly and send request to the database. I send the ISP number, then if search in database, if book not found will raise exception, if not is found will return the book again. And the proxy apply the same or implement the same interface, but here will not call the database, it will call the cache memory. I create a hash map. This hash map will store all requests. First of all, if I call the download book, first should be searched in this is hash table. If not found, so that here it will route again to the business service to search in database and print this is in database. If from cache, it will print from cache. Then download the book. Okay. Second time, now the cache server contains this book, so that find the book and download directly without go to database. This is will increase the performance and decrease the round trip to the database. This is example for caching in memory cache. I have another example for here. We have to get check out the MongoDB. In this branch, I apply different type of caching server. This is a MongoDB, so that if we open the proxy, in this proxy now we use the we don't use the cache. Or the hash map, or maybe memory cache. We use the Mongo MongoDB server. Just we save the book detail inside the Mongo server instead of using memory cache. Try to restart, and try to call again. This is cache, try to clean the cache. Now the cache cleaned. Try to call the same book. Okay, now first download the book from the table or database. Another time we'll get from cache. Let us open the Mongo books. Fresh. If we open the box, we have this book. Try to another book. Enter new ISP number 220. This is just a demo. And 2. Then check from database. Another time from the Mongo, open the Mongo again, refresh, okay, now we have the two requests. The first of all, console? Books?
Okay,
release all books. Now, first, it will search in cache. If not found in cache, we'll search in database and get the request and save request in the cache server. The second time, we'll get or fetch the book detail from cache. Open book. This is the book, the author details, all book details here, the pattern, all details will come in cache server. Now, if you try to cache or download a book again, it will be very, very fast because we don't go to the database and our connection and download the books. So that if we use the caching or filtering, or if we need to apply, have to use the proxy design pattern. I hope you enjoy today with this is amazing and wonderful design pattern, and I will apply, I will upload our code in our repository. I will send this is in our repository. All code will find here. Even we have two branches, Mongo deep branch and the master branch, so that you can download and try to test your first caching server. Thank you all and good morning.